I like right there. I love this like title screen of this demo version we've got, because like right there visually, like
it's
you
so
see those
intense.
Arms. Like.
Yeah, it's kind of what you do, right? I mean, you kind of throw a punch and you kind of hit the person in the face, right? I mean, it's kind of what it is. Yeah. And if you'll notice, I'll talk about the backgrounds later and stuff too, but we'll get into it. So there's a couple characters in this particular demo. There's five of them, but I'll start with Springman first, and I'll just kind of go into kind of basics and kind of teach you guys how to play, how it works, and we'll go from there. So as you can see, I'm holding the Joy-Con up in kind of like this thumbs up grip style. So like kind of the face, like the ABXY buttons and all the sticks are kind of facing in, and then I have my thumbs on the L and R buttons up top like this. So I'm just gonna press L and R with my thumbs like this, and we're in. Now the motion, the way it works is you're going to tilt gently the side, and we saw this a little bit last night where he was kind of like tilting a little bit, you saw it in the video, so we're going to tilt a little bit just to move. You don't need a lot. Okay. You also tilt forward and back like that. And with your left thumb, you can actually press the L button to dash, so you can actually just move forward and dash this way. You could dash to the left, dash to the right, all it takes is one button. So it's, you know, in general, you know, it's really simple, right? So R button with your right thumb, jump like that.
I'm digging this enemy that you're going up against.
Yeah, oh, Master Mummy? Oh,
yeah.
he'll be digging me in a second. So to punch is actually interesting because your hands, these punches are more like Wing Chun punches, I call them, like thumbs up punches. So you want to punch straight and flick. It's nice straight flick. And notice how the fist travels straight, right? You can throw it with your right hand, left hand. And it says twist or curve your punches, so really it's a two-step punch. So the moment after you flick, you want to gently kind of rock your right hand to the inside or rock it to the outside. So it's one kind of fluent motion, and that's all it takes. It's very, very simple.
That's where the movement magic starts. That's like the first little nibble of like the, oh my, where that depth comes from. And we're going to learn to that.
Oh my gosh, dude. Like, I will break this thing down. And so we already talked about, you know, curving your punches and stuff. But what that does is, you know, if you think about how they're standing, it's you really have to kind of track and predict where the other person's going to go and then, you know, guide your punch to their face. See? I'm going to go back to the face punching thing.
Master Mummy's totally going easy on you right now.
Yeah, so if you flick with both hands and punch with both hands straight at the same time, you will grab.
Nice.
So now we have kind of the basics of every fighting game, right? You have movement, you have punches, and now you have throws. And don't worry, we'll get into a couple other stuff. So in the bottom right corner, you see the little triangle? It's kind of like on yellow flames and stuff.
Yep.
If you press the ZR button with your right thumb, you can press it, okay. And then you just kind of flick both hands and punch both hands forward a little bit, and there you go. Just totally rock the other person with a super move. All right. So let me go ahead and press the L and R buttons, and let's get to a fight, yeah?
Master Mummy's so mad that he had to sit there in training, or you just beat up on him, I think.
Sit there and take it? Oh, man. I wish all my opponents were that easy. There'd just be a training dummy. But that's not the case. I mean, this game
is.
It would be fun, but let me tell you, man, it's all about reading the other person and what they're doing. So, what's interesting about this game is also selection of arms. You'll notice that Springman actually has, you know, a couple different options. And each of these arms on the left and right hands, I can pick independently. So, just for this round,
toaster.
I'm going to pick. You want the toaster? Okay, I'll
oh,
pick
one
toaster.
Of the toasters, yeah.
Okay, toaster on my left hand, and what, boomerang or trident with the other?
Boomerang's good. That'll show boomerang. Some of the. That'll accentuate sort of the curve you get on some of those punches.
Oh, man, that's exactly what I'm going to do. So, I'm going to go ahead and select these. So, press L and R to confirm, and we're off and running. Now, so another thing I want to show is blocking. So, and I'll go back into why blocking is important in a second. No. Well, not because of defense, but other things. So, notice how my left hand, when I throw it out straight, I can hit him. But strategically, what I like doing, since I have the boomerang in my right hand, I'm going to flick out the boomerang, force him that way, and he has to deal with that. And
oh, there
he is. See if I get my pulse enough. Oh, trouble up. Motion's important.
Yeah, and you guys saw there what JC did. You can sort of see there's like these little exclamation points that start to show up on the shoulders and arms. So the arms, as they take damage left and right, sort of get staggered. And that'll load. And that's something you have to sort of, if you get one of your arms negated, like your right arm goes down, you can't block with that.
Exactly. And further, you know, I just, the Master Mummy did this to me. I tried to throw, and he punched through them. So they're, oh boy, move. Nope.
Yikes.
Nope. Trampoline. Whoop.
That was good. So you saw that he unleashed his flurry of punches.
Oh, I tried to combo it, because you can actually, you know, knock him into those, the trampolines in the back, and then combo again when he's juggling midair. So I totally missed it, though. Oh, there you go.
Oh, that was nice.
We got this. Oh, that was bad. Wait. Throw a punch. Oh, too slow. Wait. I'm just going to do this and finish him off.
Oh, that was nice.
So strategically, depending on the arms that I pick, I'm always thinking, okay, the boomerang technically goes around arms. So I know that my fists aren't going to clash with his with that. So I always lead with the boomerang first to get him to move and to get him to punch. So that's kind of the way I think about the boomerang in this particular matchup. Now, I'm going to trade a little bit and use the trident and kind of show you some advanced stuff. So let's switch it up now. I'll do trident in my left hand, and my right hand I'll do toaster.
Yeah, and you can see this is the best 2 out of 3 match. JC's got a little one win up in the left corner. You can see his little icon with a little blue dot.
And you can see our health bars. So mine's in the bottom right. And I can see Master Mummy's. It's right over his head in the top right. So he's got his. Oh, I was so glad I was watching.
Wow.
Look at that. It's very serendipitous. It was totally. And always, movement is life, man.
He and wants his revenge.
He does.
He seeks revenge.
Oh, you ain't getting nothing. I got it. Oh, no.
Oh, you were lucky there. Both your arms were gone.
Yeah, and I realized that, you know, picking the trident against Master Mummy was not a smart idea because both of his arms can actually go through my left hand. See, the trident covers a lot of ground, but it's weak. See how that went right through?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was actually not very smart against this matchup. I should have thought about that, which, again, it's deep, dude. I didn't have to tell you this, but I'll keep talking about, you know, rock, paper, scissors games and fighting games. But wait, give me a second. There, he's over. Eat it. There you go.
That was nice. Very nice.
Whoa! Okay. Come on. So, this is actually really hard to actually talk while I'm doing this, but... Let me see. Oh, he totally let that punch. That was good. Oh, gosh. See, what he's doing is the reason why I keep getting shocked is he's powering up those punches. And when he powers up the punches, I can power it up.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
And you wake up.
This is a close one.
I'm gonna grab. Oh, close one.
You got your flurry.
Ah,
yeah.
Got it.
There
I was
go.
So good. Okay, so let me kind of go what you're seeing here. So essentially, you're really throwing out 3 different types of moves, right? Technically, I have a punch, I have a throw, and I have a block, which I didn't actually use very much because I actually like moving around and kind of dodging around them instead. Now, it's kind of a basic staple in fighting games, so where it's a rock, paper, scissor game, right? It's hits wins over like throws wins over blocks, and blocks usually wins over, you know, punches. And what ends up happening is if you dodge, you move out of that rock, paper, scissor game because you can't do any damage, but you can't accept any damage either, right? So let me go ahead and... pick somebody else. Who should I pick?
Why don't you... Let's see. Maybe
go Master Mummy.
Maybe Ribbon Girl.
Ribbon Girl? Okay, I'll do Ribbon Girl.
Ready?
Okay.
And JC, it's important to point out that you've been playing with the Joy-Con one in each hand.
Yes.
I'm sort of using motion controls, but there is obviously, if you're a purist and you like button controls, and you'd rather use a more traditional controller, you could, of course, do that as well.
You can. But for me personally, I got so used to doing this that, you know, I'm all about... You know, the motion. I kind of got used to it. And
oh no,
it's kind of like Splatoon. Once you get used to it, it's really hard.
What's great about ARMS, like, just to make the point, is like, it's a game that you can pick up. You pick up the Joy-Con, one in each hand, and because you have one in each hand, like, your movements are really translated almost completely on screen, and you feel like you know what you're doing right away. Like, you're almost immediately, like, functional at playing the game pretty good. But then the more you play, the more you start to find that depth of controls. And I think the people that, once they get their hands on this game, are really going to, like, appreciate, like, how much. The Joy-Con brings to that game, to the game, and just discovering that depth.
Yeah, and JC, you were talking about how as you throw the punch, you can actually feel the arms extending and unraveling.
Oh, is he? That's weird. HD Rumble?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember the first time I got this, I was like, wait a minute, this is super weird.
Like, kind of disorienting.
No, it feels like it's weird. Like, the best way to describe it is it feels like something's traveling out of your hand. Like, if I'm punching a ribbon, it feels
amazing.
Like a ribbon's, like, unraveling and traveling that way. I don't know how else to explain it, but that's the best I can do, man.
So you've got Ribbon Girl this time. And so as you guys probably noticed, he's got the different selection of arm attachments. Mm-hmm. So the characters are, you know, the character models are one thing. And then they sort of have a stock set of 3 in this demo version of attachable arms.
And I'm going to go ahead and pick the Sparky and Slap-A-Mander. And I'm going to get into a couple things.
Slap-A-Mander.
I love this thing. What's interesting is, you know, if you think about... You know, you think about different fighting games, and I play a lot of them at work. I know you guys probably see me in Smash Bros. Just like after work every day. You know, I'm really about thinking about what are the, like, you know, it takes a lot in other fighting games to have access to, you know, rock, paper, or scissor. In
nice
both
grab.
Of those.
I like how that, you notice both of his arms were knocked down, and then you immediately went in.
That's a strat, man. That's legit. Oh, you unlocked the trampoline in the middle of the stage. Hold on. I love this. Oh, totally grasped me. But, the thing that really gets you about it is you have options to really get to everything. I mean, really, all you need to do is either you're flicking both hands forward at the same time to throw, or you're flicking, you know, one to punch, or you're doing this to block. So every motion you have is very simple, and it's simple button controls too. You only have technically 2 buttons to, you know, to press. So it's very simple, but it gets very deep really quickly when you figure out how to use them and what your movement options are and what the optimal leading off of that. Oh,
nice.
Is that combos? Anyway.
I don't know if people caught it either, but just a moment ago, Ninjara, like, disappeared for a second in a puff of smoke, and then he was, like, back in another area.
Ah,
so
yeah.
Super sweet.
Yeah,
so
we'll talk about that, too. I think
Yeah.
The characters each have their own sort of unique feature characteristics.
Yeah, they have like their thing. You know what I mean? Like they all have their thing. So here, let's restart another one. And
you just went 2-0 against the CPU, but I think it's time to fight somebody. Maybe you know, I've been practicing.
If you want some, come get some.
I'm gonna grab my own set of Joy-Con here. I get the colored ones, which are really exciting.
You know, while you're putting those on, I will talk about this. So I kind of maybe let's I'll go into two players and I'm gonna pause right here on the screen for a bit so we can check out the characters. Mm-hmm. So Springman's kind of balanced and all around. He has great motion. He has a lot of option like for movement. He has a good, you know, the jump and the dash has a good length and it's pretty standard. It's actually a little better than everybody else's. When it comes to Ribbon Girl, I don't know if you noticed this, but the last game I was jumping like 4 or 5 times.
Here, I'll go on the same one. So
yeah, you could totally
jumpy.
Do that. I was all about, dude, if you can control the vertical space, it's actually really hard for, she's hard to hit. Ninjara, you know, I think he was my opponent like one of the rounds before, and you said he disappeared in a puff of smoke. If you block and a punch is coming toward you, Ninjara will disappear and reappear depending on what side the punch is coming from. And then you have frame advantage on how to actually hit.
Yeah, and what's really cool too about the dev team, I think, has done such an amazing job with the IP because, like, the characters are sort of, you know, they have these extendable arms, and the character design, like, you know, Springman has springs, Ribbon Girl has ribbons. Mm-hmm. Ninjara, if you didn't notice, had chains for arms.
Yeah, chains
Master
for
Mummy has, like, gauze. You know, so it's all things that, like, are believably extendable in this magical world they've created. So,
you know, man, it's almost like a World Cupping, like, sporting event. Almost, you know, like, anyway, so Master Mummy is kind of interesting because he has a little bit of super armor, which means he can take like a hit or two, but at the same time, if he blocks, he's a tank. If he blocks, you'll see him heal, so you don't want to leave him just by himself blocking because he'll just start healing. When it comes to Mechanica can jump.
I love
her. I know, right? She's actually really cool. Aside from just jumping multiple times, she can actually press the R button and hold it down, and she can steer herself in flight in midair.
Yeah.
So you have a ton of different options, and depending who you choose, kind of, and the arms you choose, kind of changes the way you play the character.
Yeah. So let's choose two of the ones maybe we haven't seen yet. You played as Ribbon Girl and Springman, so who do you want to? And you fought Master Mummy, so should we bust out?
One Ninjara.
Ninjara and Mechanica maybe.
Oh sure, yeah, you want to do that? Here, I'll pick Ninjara. There you go.
I love his chain sunglasses too. Like wearing like
sorry, man. They kind of went out the character designs. And what's funny is if you look in the background, you'll also notice that depending who we pick, those people in the background are cheering for me. So you see some Ninjara fans, and you're going to see like, you know, Mechanica fans in the background right now. They're all cheering, and they have different stuff. All right. Anyway, different weapons here. I like the Sparky, and because you can charge up some punches. So I'm going to use the Sparky to charge up. I'm telling you my strategy here.
Yeah.
And I'm going to pick the Chakram to kind of lead you. There you go. So Sparky and Chakram for
I'm going to use the Toaster, which is also pretty standard, and the Boomerang to get some nice curves going.
Okay, in my head, I got
to... Let's just take a second to show sort of a... Before we start beating each other up too much, let's show
also,
a little bit more of
break,
that. Yeah, well, let's show sort of visually what you're talking about, sort of that rock, paper, scissors of like what works.
That's good. So
what do you want to show first? So right now I'm blocking. I'm tilting
my... Okay, so you're blocking, so I'm going to punch real quick. You can see that nothing really happens.
With either hand.
Yep. But if I throw, right? This is the counter. If I throw like that, that wins over blocks, right?
And
then if you do you want to?
I'm gonna block again, and now throw that. Go ahead and put the throw at me.
Throw's coming. Here we go. Go throw. And notice how his punch breaks throws. So it's you have to really understand what's their habit. How often is Morgan punching? I'm always thinking, how far is he away from me? What's the best weapon for me to use?
Yeah, and what's coming at me? Is it one arm? Is it two coming in for a grab?
Yeah, I mean, you have to kind of read it. But really, it's simple because all you have to do is know either to flick with one hand, flick with two, block, or just move.
Yep.
Like, it's all here. You don't, I mean, it's simple. It's really simple. You just have to, it's up in here is where, in your head. Try to get in their head. All right, you ready for this?
Yep.
Right. Well, I'm going to talk about my strategy while I'm hopefully beating you up here. So at the end of every jump and dash, you'll see that I'm going to power up my punches, and my punch actually is charged a little bit. So I'm charging my punch on purpose. These punches become a little bit more powerful, and they have status effects depending if you can hit with that. Yeah, so what I'm doing with my strategy is my left hand is a Sparky. So if I dash or jump and dash, like that at the end of it and throw this out, it stunned him. That's kind of my goal. And then I hit him with the Chakram. See? Look how much damage that does. Oh. It's all right. I would kind of call that one. Oh, yeah, we'll call it. We were messing around.
We were sharing a lot of knowledge, you know. Timer ran out, so.
So okay.
This next match, we can go out a little
bit. For real. This is like realsies this time. Okay. I'm also right now kind of thinking meta. I'm like thinking, like, what's he going to pick? And that's actually a really good choice. Oh, jeez. You know what? I'm going to stick with the same plan. I have an idea. All right. prepared.
Interesting. I figured to. The charge meter actually carries over from matches, so I already had my special ready. Pretty cool, actually.
See how I'm just disappearing? I'm not using that a lot, am I, Morgan?
I love how you guys can interact with the stages as well, like on the outer rims, you've got like the bouncy.
Oh yeah, and I'm using it too.
Yeah.
That was good.
I was like, do it. Throw or punch.
I was going to throw a grab as soon as you landed and you dodged it there.
Throw combination, dude. Just you have to keep the other person under pressure, especially with Ninjar. He's the kind of character you want. Oh, you missed. Don't miss, bro. Don't miss.
Style.
I'm like listening to you talk. I'm like, I'm learning so much from JC as I'm getting beat up.
It's really important. You have to study the other person. It's all about reading.
Yeah.
Because it's all about reading.
Yeah,
about
but
reading
he looks stylish while he's doing it.
On Ninjar, always.
Yeah.
He's got those glasses in his arm. He's fine. Look at those chains.
All right, so
you want me to switch?
This time? You want to switch?
I'll switch. I want Master Mummy because I love playing as Master Mummy. He's arguably my favorite character. Because
all right, I'm going to go back to Rhythm Girl.
In a way, it's really annoying. Oh man, it's so good to be able to like talk like this. It's so cool. I've been waiting so long to talk about this, man.
I know.
You see me at my desk like playing like every day.
Do you think you can handle double slapper manners?
Actually, yes, I can.
Double slappies.
I don't think.
Yes, I can. You can't handle these double revolvers, though. You can't. Handle. And then this is weird. Now, the one I have is the revolvers, which is interesting because there's three different shots in a row that kind of puts it out there.
Oh, my God.
And he does a lot of damage if you can connect with these. And it's really hard for some characters, if you don't know the right motion options, to just get eaten up, like, hard by these dudes. Like, it's...
So each one comes out sequentially, and then you can like, have a hook in there toward the end, and then it'll take a turn.
Ooh.
Oh, you totally countered my flurry, though.
We'll see a stage in a bit where you can, like, use those hooks with the stage.
Oh, good. That was a wake-up throw. I did not see that one coming. Don't do it! Oh,
I used my double jump to try to avoid that.
Right. It's so funny because
I almost got over the top.
So let me talk a little bit about strategy. So even when you have and you use your ZR move, there's actually a little bit of a delay, but you get extremely powerful moves. So what I was trying to do with the revolver was delay it one hand by one hand so everything would combo at the same time.
Yeah.
So there's, you got to know those things. And you'll learn them pretty easily, but let me see. All right, I'm gonna pick first. I love his revolver, man. It's so good.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, his revolver's hard to counter because it comes out, like, staggered, you know?
And you have to keep moving.
Well, because you have to wait longer, whereas the, like, the trident, which you saw, that sends three out as well.
Oh. Ooh, that was smart. Oh, yeah? That goes through all of them, buddy. I got you. Oh, no! I'm in trouble here. Oh.
You should do the heel. Do the heel so we can... So we can show the audience.
Oh, how in the heck?
Oh, he's throwing me. He's good.
I know that you're slower, so I have a little advantage on speed, so I have to try to use that.
There we go.
Oh, no.
Okay, so.
I was trying to heal, but he's actually reading the heal, and he's throwing me now.
Yeah, but you can see he was like, there it is. Yeah, he's absorbing souls into his body so that
Uh-oh,
he can heal.
That's bad.
Oh, what? Okay.
I didn't make out of that one, man.
I feel like Ribbon Girl is really well matched to Master Mummy too, because she's super bouncy and she's really fast, so she kind of counteracts his like big beefy slower moves.
That's true.
All right, it's 1-1. This will be a fun one.
It will. Now, what to pick?
I know.
I want to go two big punches. I want to count the homie. You know what? I have an idea.
It's interesting too, because like I feel like you have a dominant hand left or right, but also sometimes like if your right hand goes down in the game and you're going to block with it and the arm's disabled, you have to use your left. So you have to be always ready at any time to use both hands.
That's true.
And it kind of depends on which one you have on each side too.
That's true. I mean, what's funny is every time you have like one of your arms goes down and it's like red, you have very limited movement options. Also, you start to get really like, oh no, like you're kind of stuck, right? You're kind of sitting there and it's not no bueno. Oh, that was a grab. Good read.
Play chicken now. I'm a little intimidated because this is Master Mummy's stage. You know, I can see his logo in the middle of that trampoline in the middle.
There we go. Get in there. Oh, slow.
Nice.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's bad. Jeez, look at that combo. Man. That was all the... Oh, he's reading the throw. Okay, so I have to think about this now. There we go. It's all reaction. Oh, boy. Oh, this is not looking good for Master Mummy. Oh!
No. What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Nothing.
Oh, man. Why did I fall for that?
See, I'm healing. I'm good. Oh, that was smart. Oh, I missed.
Barely.
Oh, no.
Here comes. Oh, my gosh. Like a sliver of health.
I'm good.
I'm good.
He's regenerating. We're good. Don't panic.
Dang.
No.
Oh wow. Nice.
Good win. That was good.
I was scared though, because like I know that you're back there just like tanking up and like regenerating, but I don't want to get too greedy and try to, you know.
That's true. That was good. That was really good.
That was good.
Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, this is the kind of game where I'm always like, you know, thinking of different ways to like approach the match.
Yeah, you can't really ever take a minute off mentally because you're always having to react to what your opponent's doing or looking for an opening. Mm-hmm. And it takes a while to sort of in your head to like figure out all the pieces you're looking for. Are you looking for two hands coming at you? You know, am I going to stagger those like we talked about? Or is one of your arms disabled? So I'll try to knock that one down. And then once you have one arm disabled, I can get more aggressive. Mm-hmm.
It's all flicks. It's all right here. It.
So, all right. So I think we have time for one more match.
Yeah, you want more?
Definitely.
And we've been talking a lot during these, but I think it's time for us to really just
go for it.
Play for the champion, okay. World champion,
world. Can you call it that?
Yeah. Well, I mean, the game's not out yet.
Yeah,
so.
I was gonna
That's
say.
That's true.
Actually.
Treehouse Live champion,
like best in the world or something. Yeah. It's like, it's fine, right?
Treehouse Live champion. I'm gonna go with.
Okay, I'm. Let's see.
I'm gonna go.
Ribbon Girl.
You're gonna go Ribbon Girl. I think I'm going to go...
She's really my lady, though. I like Master Mummy, but really most...
I think I'm going to go back to Mechanica. I lost earlier with her, so I'm going to try to... I'm going to try to... redeem myself, I think.
Yeah.
Remember, you can fly. You can fly temporarily. Okay. All right, for real this time. For realsies.
It's also a bit of a chess match. Like, I'm like, which arms am I going to be most effective against your fighting style? I'm going to start off with this.
I'm also picking
straight up. Yeah,
purposefully picking something to freeze organ in the air.
Ooh. Not a good start.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh, nice.
Oh yeah?
Oh.
Morgan wanted me to like sports commentate, but then I was like, I have no idea how to sports commentate, so
nice.
we're just gonna let the
This stage is interesting too.
Beat each other up.
You can also wake up.
No.
Okay, so
nice.
So what I was doing is actually using my left hand to lead first because the Slap Commander takes time to charge when it's ZR powered up. So I was doing this to lead to get you to open and then I'm using that. So again, learn to use your weapons, y'all. Alright, if he
Hopper.
Was doing that, then I should probably Okay.
Nice.
Slightly different approach this time.
We didn't get a chance to show it this time, but obviously, there are a ton of different stages, and in some of the stages, you can interact quite a bit with the stage and use it to your advantage or disadvantage. So, we'll have to check that out another time for sure. Oh.
Good. That was really good.
Nice grab.
I know it's definitely like an adjustment because I was using Ribbon Girl last time, working that triple jump, and now my jump is much slower. But like you said, I have that hover, so it's just I have to adjust to sort of using that to my advantage.
There you go, counter throw. Was reading that. There.
Oh no.
Dodging.
No.
There you go.
Close.
Oh.
One and one.
Woo. All right.
You guys are so in the zone.
I know.
You gotta focus, man. Don't take your. You know, it's like kind of like fighting games. You don't look at yourself. You look at him.
I should have quit after the last match. All right, match two.
You want Ribbon Girl again? You want me to switch?
I haven't used Ninjara yet, so I'm gonna bust out Ninjara.
Okay. Awesome. I'll take a Ribbon Girl. Ready? Take on the Ribbon Girl.
Yes. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad.
I love. Okay.
I know. I was hoping for this stage.
Okay, good. So, okay, and now I'm actually gonna change. Hold on. I'm gonna change.
Now you guys will see what I was talking about earlier.
I'm gonna use.
So it's not just
the stages come into play very differently here. So I'm actually gonna talk about it real quick.
Let's show a little of the stage off.
So
now you beat me in the last match. I mean, I'm willing to concede you're okay, momentarily better at this.
Okay, so if you take a look at what's happening here, there's some columns in the middle that can be broken, but I also have to play around them. So I can use this as cover. I can throw him through them.
You can even destroy him. Well, I was gonna say, you can even try to curve your punches around them.
You can. So what's funny is I think your chakras can do it if you flick to the side.
Yeah, so let me back up a little bit. So
go ahead.
I'm gonna go out.
You can flick out that way, or I can flick out my slab. Yeah, that way. I can flick this one out that way too. So I can attack around if I want to keep my guard. So you have to kind of pay attention to what arena you're in, and what obstacles are in there. So
or if you get really annoyed with it, just take that goose right out.
Destroy them all.
Oops. That was kind of dirty. Here, I'll get you a free throw. We'll make it fair. Throw me. I kind of took advantage.
All right.
Okay, now we're even.
Are you ready now?
To go? All right. Seriously.
Let's go. Nope. Ooh. Oh, man. Oh. I was trying to catch you, like.
Oh, the tracking.
Wow.
Good. Okay, I'm going to wake it this way. Dodge.
So, as you guys can see, Ribbon Girl's special is fired up.
I know.
Oh, no. Double team tank knockout. Did you see that?
That's right.
Ready.
Oh, man.
And the extra damage it got you, too. Okay. Surprise. You're in the corner.
Oh, we're pretty neck and neck.
No. Stay in the corner. Don't go anywhere. Stay in the corner. Stay in the corner. Where are you going?
Oh, one last slap.
I know, right?
As time expired.
So, again, that's the whole thing, understanding your arena. Noticing that I wasn't throwing punches out. I needed to keep you in the corner.
Yep.
Nobody puts baby in the corner. All right. Let me see. Tanks are gone, so I'm not going to use them. Oh, that was cool. All right. Let's go, Morgan. Let's go.
I've got my special ready, and I'm going to make you feel the wrath.
Oh,
nice.
Yeah. I'm just trying to keep moving. You don't want to sit against Ninjara. Dude. You do not sit. Like, you have to. Oh, I totally missed those. There it is. Open.
No.
Oh, they wanted to end it with a grab. Yes.
Come on, we can get the Trio of Life,
Oh, no!
Oh, my God.
Never give up.
Don't you use those pepper bombs on me. This sets us up.
Oh gosh. Okay.
And this is gonna end our segment. Last round.
How about this loser gets the other person a drink of water?
Yeah.
Give me a glass of water after this.
I'm quite parched.
Okay. Yep. I just admitted.
All right.
Okay. No. We're not losing here. No.
No pressure.
Not at all.
I like that over the course of our match, we've destroyed every tank. So this game. Is why am I talking?
Oh! No, man. Focus.
Here we go!
Oh, no!
Wow.
I tried to air dodge to my right, and I air dodged straight into you.
Oh, man, that was... Okay, I'll say it.
GG.
I'll say you got lucky, but yeah, GG's, man. Yeah. Seriously, that was good. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. That was...
Thank you!
That was nice.
We'll be right back.